Hello everyone, it is a great honor to join in KubeCon and Cloud Native Con North America to share the Dragonfly. This is also my second time joining KubeCon to share Dragonfly. Unable to attend offline sessions due to COVID-19. I hope listeners can have the same experience as offline. The sharing is accelerates image distribution in multi-clusters with Dragonfly, which introduce new features and experience in multi-cluster that have been added to Dragonfly in last year. My name is Qi Wenbo. My English name is Gaius. I'm a software engineer at Ant Group working on Dragonfly. I'm also a maintainer of the Dragonfly. If users have problems during the use of the Dragonfly, you can communicate with me. I hope to have more exchange with you on the new features of the Dragonfly in the future. First, let's introduce the Dragonfly project and some of our research and deployment data in the past year. Dragonfly is an open-source P2P-based image and file distribution system. It designs to improve the speed of the large-scale file distributions. It is used in the fields of application distribution, cache distribution, log distribution, and image distribution. At this stage, Dragonfly has evolved based on Dragonfly 1 on the basis of the maintaining the core capabilities of Dragonfly 1. Dragonfly, it has been upgraded in major features such as system architecture design, product capabilities, and use signature. Dragonfly has been selected and put into production used by many internet companies since its open source in 2017 and entered SynSAP in October 2018, becoming the third project in China to enter the SynSAP sandbox. In 2020, SynSAP TOC voted to accept Dragonfly as a SynSAP incubating project. Dragonfly has developed the next version through production, which has absorbed the advantage of Dragonfly 1 and made a lot of solved for known problems. Now that Dragonfly has been released more than 120 times, the project has active commits for a long time. We can refer to the first picture, which is the commit date for the past year. I would also like to thanks to contributors from different companies, include but not limited to these companies, such as Ant Group, Alibaba Cloud, ByteDance, GitLab, Meituan, Xiaomi, Langchao, Shanghai Jiao Tong University. Listeners who are interested in the project can join in the communities through the link below and discuss the future deployment of the project with us. Some listeners may not know much about the Dragonfly project. I will introduce the architecture of the Dragonfly project and the role of each service. First, Dragonfly includes manager, scheduler, seed peer, and peer. The manager module in the project can be used as a manager service. The scheduler module in the project can be used as a scheduler service. The DF daemon module in the project can be used as a seed peer service or seed peer or peer service. We can refer to the architecture picture on the right. When the peer downloads task, it will call the scheduler API to get the list of the candidate parents. If the task is downloaded for the first time in the P2P network, the scheduler will trigger the seed peer to download back to source. After the peer gets the candidate parents, it will download the required piece from the parents. The manager can provide the available scheduler address and the available seed peer address to peers in the cluster, and manage the relationship between multiple clusters, and manage the stability of the clusters. We introduce each service. First of all, the manager service, which is a management service. It is used to manage the relationship between multiple clusters. A P2P cluster includes a scheduler cluster, a seed peer cluster, and multiple peers. Multiple P2P schedulers are managed by the manager. At the same time, manager also provides dynamic configuration management, such as controlling the load of the peer and seed peer. The manager can also become a certificate issuing CA service, issuing lift certificates to scheduler, seed peer, and peer. It also provides a front-end console, which is convenient for users to manage P2P clusters. It also provides user-related features such as user module management and RBAC. Also provide open API such as preheat API to be coded by other services. Of course, the main feature of a manager is to manage the stability of the cluster. It can remove inactive service address from the cluster. Scheduler is a very important service in the Dragonfly. Its main feature is to select the candidate download parents for download peer. When the peer download is failed, control the peer to back to source download task. Of course, the scheduling is still very complicated. It will build a DAG of peers, and in the scheduling, it will go through filter and evaluate to select candidate parents. Seed peer can be triggered by the scheduler to download back to source and divide the resource into pieces, which can be used as the root node of the cluster resource. And it also has a feature of a peer. Usually, seed peers in the cluster provide a high performance machine and a high quality network environment. When downloading tasks for the first time, they can back to source download the resource at the faster speed. Peer is the client in P2P network. It can be the downloader and the uploader. It will start a dfget daemon to distribution image. It gets the parents by exchanging information with the scheduler. The dfget daemon and the dfdaemon extensions dfget, dfstore, and dfcache command line tools RCS architecture. For example, dfget will download files with the command line, and dfget will call the gRPC API of daemon to download files. This page introduces some major updates. First of all, we have three main improvements in terms of stability. We replaced the CDN with seed pairs to improve the stability. The stability of the cluster is ensured by keep alive between each service and the manager. If there is an error on the instance, the manager will delete the instance from the cluster. At the same time, we use a gRPC consistency hash to ensure the cache hit rate and resolve the gRPC address in case of call exceptions. In terms of the security, use the manager as a CA to issue certificate to ensure that TLS is used during the transmission of P2P traffic. We return the scheduling result through two steps of feather and evaluate it, and use the DAG mask to form a P2P network to improve the download efficiency. Use seed peer instead of CDN service because CDN is a separate module before, and it can be actively triggered back to source downloading. So the current version removes CDN and the dfdaemon as triggered back to source downloading API. It reduces maintenance costs for CDN modules. This can also clearly define the role of different types of peers in the P2P network, rather than adding a new service. The above picture shows a download process. First, peer will async get the most matching scheduler address from the manager. Then peer rejects tasks with scheduler, and peer then build a bidirectional stream with scheduler. If the task is downloaded for the first time, the scheduler will trigger the seed peer to download back to source. The scheduler returns the candidate parents to the peer. Then peer will download the piece from the parents and build the piece into a completed file. Users can deploy the seed peer in a place where the network environment of the source is better, so as to ensure that the first time back to source is as fast as possible. The manager can manage the stability of the cluster through keep alive. First, the scheduler will start and then report his host information to the manager and keep alive with the manager. And then the manager will record the scheduler state as active. If keep alive is disconnected, the manager will set the scheduler state to inactive, and the scheduler will get the address of the active seed peer to trigger the back to source download. After the seed peer is started, it should also report its own host information and keep alive with the manager. The manager sets the seed peer state to active. If keep alive is disconnected, the manager will set the state of the seed peer to inactive. When peer starts, it will pull the list of the address, the scheduler address, whose state is active and matching from the manager according to its own host information, and provide it for scheduling use one downloading task. During the process, the peer uses the scheduler address. The scheduler uses the set peer address, and the manager the routing through the manager. When the service has an error, the manager will set service state to inactive and remove the service from the cluster. This way, we can manage the stability of the P2P cluster. Dragonfly manages the cache hit rate of downloads through consistent hashing. Consistent hashing is done by gRPC balancer and the resolve builder. The peer gets the matching scheduler address with the active state from the manager, then add the address to the gRPC address list through resolver builder. When the peak builder is built, the address of resolve will be built into a consistent hashing. When peaker peaks, it finds the matching scheduler address in the consistent hashing according to the download task ID and use the this address for peer scheduling. If exception is on a scheduler, the gRPC request will fail, and the resolver will resolve the new available scheduler address from the manager and rebuild the consistent hashing. And the peer will also update the available scheduler address, rebuild the consistent hashing. It can not only ensure that the same task ID can hit a scheduler, but also delete the inactive scheduler address in time. Let's talk about how the call service scheduler of the Dragonfly schedules tasks. Scheduling is divided into two steps, feather and evaluate. When the peer exchanges scheduling information with the scheduler will first take out all candidate parents in the task. The scheduler will feather the unavailable parents according to the rulers. The feather and the feather based on the current parents load count. If the parents load count exceed the limit, it will feather out. If parents download state is failed, it will also be feathered out. The parent download will record the time consuming of each piece. If the piece downloading time conforms to a normal distribution, it will feather the slow downloading parent by 6 sigma based on the piece download time. The feathered parent are all available parents. The next step evaluate and scores the available parents, and then selects a set of parents with the highest scores, which is returned to the peer to download the task. The evaluate will be based on multiple features, such as the more free load the parent has left, the higher the score. If parents download more piece, the score will be higher. In the end, a score will be given to each available parent, then sorted and the set of parent with the highest score will be selected and returned as the scheduling result. The scheduling process is building a DAG for the peer. Why build a DAG? There are two reasons. The first reason is that in Dragonfly's P2P network, there is no peer that publish results. The real results in the Dragonfly come from the source site. If it is an image downloading, it may be a harbor. The real results needs to be downloaded from the source site to the P2P network through a peer, and other peers can download it. If peer A downloads from peer B downloads from peer C, and peer C downloads from peer A, none of the peer downloads real results back to source, forming a download loop. In this way, peer cannot download real results. So when building a network, there can be no loop, and a peer can download piece from multiple parents. So the network must be a graph. Therefore, it's necessary to build a peer download network in scheduling, which needs to build a DAG. The early version used a tree, which made it possible to indicate that the peer downloads from multiple parents. It can only indicate that the peer downloads from one parent, which will reduce the download success rate. The following size of data are files of different size, which represent the difference in downloaded data caused by the P2P network in the form of a tree or a DAG. Peers are deployed in different IDCs, so the bandwidth between peer is not fixed, and there is only one peer back to source download task, and we will increase the number of peers in the P2P network to get the final date. First of all, we can look at the picture. One downloading task, no matter how many peers are, the download bandwidth of DAG is larger than that of the tree. And in the case of more peers, the greater the impact of the download bandwidth. We can see that when downloading a 1 gigabyte task, the data on the graph is compared, and the DAG will be better, bandwidth would be better. When downloading 10 gigabyte task, the data of DAG will be better compared to tree. So changing the P2P network from tree to DAG can improve bandwidth usage. In terms of transmission security, Dragonfly has also been upgraded. Dragonfly for the transmission process, most of which are based on mutuals, TLS. Manager is Dragonfly's CA and issue certificates for each service. Each service will call the manager API to get certificate chain when it's started. Of course, users can also turn on or turn off TLS through the switch. If TLS is turned off, the communication between service will be carried out in clear text. Encrypted transmission can make P2P network transmission of information more secure and reliable. Dragonfly is based on the upload and download service provided by peer, and derives other command line tools. For example, the provided devstore command line tool provides object storage based on backend, which can quickly read and write object storage. Backend can be adapted to the object storage of cloud service, such as AWS S3 and Aliyun OSS. We can treat the P2P network as a large cache to catch the content of object storage in the peer. Below, I describe the best practice during multi-cluster deployment. First, a P2P sub-cluster consists of a set of a scheduler cluster, a set of seed peer cluster, and multiple peers. The scheduler cluster will manage the download metadata information of this P2P subcluster, helping peers to exchange data in the subcluster. Of course, a subcluster can be an independent network environment. Multiple subclusters require a manager for management. So service in multiple subclusters need to access the manager. The pictures show the multiple cluster management deployment. Users can manage multiple P2P networks isolated from multiple network environment through the manager. We will provide users with a set of image acceleration solutions based on Hub, Dragonfly, and Nydus. First, we will build the image into a Nydus image, then upload it to the Hub, and then download the image through Nydus snapshotter, which of course is a lazy load. When downloading the data of a file, it will be accelerated through the Dragonfly P2P network. In this way, users have an image acceleration solution that can be used on demand and enjoy P2P acceleration. In the future, Dragonfly has some plans for each module. We will add intelligent scheduling and will optimize the download protocol. The picture shows our future plans for each module, and interested developers can pay attention. Finally, thanks. I hope more developers can pay attention to Dragonfly. Interested developers can follow our GitHub project, or join our Slack channel, or follow our Twitter. We will release some version information and feature upgrade information, or join our discussion group. On the right is our DingTalk group QR code. You can scan the code to join our community discussion. Thank you.